everyone, and happy Wednesday. Today it is weigh-in day and meeting highlights. So if you remember my weigh-in from last week, it was less than stellar. I gained 4 pounds. Now, I was pretty sure most of that was water weight between eating a little too much takeout and not, you know, so much sodium, some woman issues, things like that. So I was pretty sure a lot of it was water, but not all of it because I ate too much. So, you know, it was what it was, and I just buckled down and did what I had to do. So I'm happy to say that this week I lost all that water weight plus a little bit more. I was down 4.8 this week, and I know it was all that water. And that solidifies my thoughts that that gain last week was water weight. My ankles were big, my fingers were sausages, so yeah. So this week I just have to stay focused, stay buckled down, and definitely, you know, keep with the program, keep doing what I'm doing, because I still do want to just a couple more pounds. I'm just not quite comfortable yet. I have a hair on my face. I'm just not quite 100% comfortable where I'm at. So, you know, I like my happy spot. So that is my weigh-in, down 4.8, which makes me very happy. Like I said, I know it was water, but I got rid of the water that I gained. So it's all good. This week's meeting topic is the last week in the What Happens to Your Body When series. It was a 6-week series, and we've had What Happens to Your Body When You Make Habits, when you exercise, when you do things like that. So there goes my kitchen timer. My breakfast is in the oven. I've got 7 minutes left on the timer to finish this video. So let's get to it. This week is what happens in your body when you create a micro habit. So basically, a micro habit is focusing in on that, fine-tuning your habit. The card says, over the past few weeks, we've learned a lot about our bodies. Now we're taking action. At the start of the series, we talked about how our brains are pretty impressive because they can change based on what we reportedly do. But that takes time. Sure, it would be great if we could press the magic button and totally transform our bodies and our habits overnight. But studies tell us that real change happens by setting small, and we mean ridiculously small, goals. By starting small, we're better set up for early and repeatable success. We can then begin to build on that micro habit to create a chain of events that leads to something bigger. What to do? Think about a habit you want to form. Break it down into the tiniest of steps. Anything sparking interest from our 6-part What Happens in Your Body series. Create a habit loop focused just on the first step and build from there. This is kind of interesting to me. And I've done this in the past, not knowing that I
camera just randomly shut off.
Thank goodness I noticed, or I would have been yapping and not recording, which may not be a bad thing sometime. Anyway, they want you to form a habit loop. The first step is the cue. Even the smallest of behaviors need a signal in the environment to actually do it. Let's say you want to practice mindful breathing for 30 seconds each morning. Decide what spot in your home will cue you to do it. We're not gonna do that. We're gonna do something else because you know I'm all about the exercise. So, and the water. So we'll do the exercise. Let's say you want to start exercising. It can be anything. Let's say you want to start walking or running or doing HIIT training or doing weights. We can use any of these as an example. But let's say that that's what you want to start. You want to start moving your body. So you need a signal in the environment to actually do it. So, let's say you want to start walking or running. put your shoes out, put your gear out the night before, put your shorts, your workout shirt, your sneakers, whatever it is. If you want to start weight training, put those weights out. Put something out so you see it. You see that and you know. That's a reminder. You know what? I want to do this. I want to commit to this. And there's my reminder and I'm going to do it. So do that. Put that out there. Just as that visual reminder, that will be your cue. You know what I struggle with. You know I struggle with my water. I need to put my water out, and maybe not just one water. Maybe I need to put one on my craft table and one in the kitchen and one in the family room, just so that visual clue is there. And then the behavior. Try out your small action and just see how doable it really is. Remember, it should be small. So let's say we wanted to walk or run. Are you going to go out and walk or run a marathon? No, we're not. Are you going to go out and walk a whole mile? Maybe not. It just depends on your situation. It depends on your physical well-being and your mental well-being. So don't feel that you have to go out and conquer the world on day one. Let's say you want to start walking or running. First day, go around the block. Go down your driveway. Walk in front of your house two or three times back and forth. That's all. That's all. Just do what you can do. And then tomorrow, maybe walk up and down your driveway twice. Maybe walk around the block a little bit faster, or maybe walk around the block twice. Each day, just, excuse me, I thought I was going to sneeze. Each day, just build a little bit more. A little bit, a little bit, a little bit. This will help form the habit. And before you know it, you will be walking or running that whole mile or more. When I started running, I didn't just jump out there and run a 5K. I trained. I used an app called C25K, Couch to 5K. I started out walking with 30-second bursts of running. Yeah, 30 seconds. That was it. You know, now I can kind of run however long I want. But I started out with 30 seconds. And guess what? It worked, and there's nothing wrong with that. We have to start small. Don't ever beat yourself up because you're not going full force. Don't ever beat yourself up or compare yourself to other people because, you know, Sally's out there running a marathon and you're walking around the block. It doesn't matter what anyone else is doing. You do what you need to do for you. Right? Right. And there's my kitchen timer again. So I'm going to go turn that off and we're going to let you look at the doggy because I don't feel like turning off my camera. So there, we're going to let Aria entertain you for just a minute. I know. I'm lazy. I am lazy because I didn't feel like shutting off my camera because it's a whole rigmarole with the sound. You know that. I've talked about that before. So anyway, that's what you have to do. And then after the cue, after the behavior comes what? The reward. By aiming small, you're setting yourself up for better satisfaction and a boost in confidence. Having early success from what you're doing makes you want to do it more, and you're a little more likely to keep up with it. So we're going to go back to the running or the walking. If you build up and build up and build up, you're going to want to keep expanding on that. Like, wow, I went around the block. I went around the block 3 days in a row. I'm going around the block twice today, you know, and then you're just going to keep building on it. You're going to keep, I don't want to say pushing yourself, but pushing yourself because you're going to want to keep getting better. you're going to want to keep bettering yourself. And that reward when you do it, I will never forget when I finished training for the 5K, the Couch to 5K. I had a 5K coming up. And the day I finished my training, it was about 2 weeks before the actual race, and it was the first time I did a 5K. I came home and I was nearly in tears because I was so happy and so proud of myself. And it took me 8 weeks to do it. Actually, it probably took me more like 10, but I did it slow, I did it right, and yeah, I stuck with it. And to this day, I'm still out there running. So it definitely works. And like I said, it doesn't necessarily have to be exercise. It can be anything. Like I said, the water. If you need to get your water in, just start small. Leave a little glass, like a little 4 ounce glass on the counter and say, you know what, I'm gonna finish this in the next 15 minutes. And then maybe do another 4 ounce glass. And then as you go on, then start using your big tumbler that's full. If you try to do that in the beginning, you're gonna be like, I can't drink all that water. There's no way. You're going to just bring yourself down. So start small. Eating your vegetables, you know, like that's it. I'm going to eat, you know, 10 servings of vegetables a day. Start small. Because if you start eating 10 servings of vegetables a day, right from, you know, scratch, that might not be a good thing for you. Other people who are used to eating vegetables all the time, it's not an issue. But for you, that might be hard. So start small. Find a veggie you like. Cut up some cucumbers, cut up some peppers, and just say, you know what? I'm going to eat a serving of cucumbers today or a serving of peppers. And then do that for a couple days and then add in something else and have 2 servings, things like that. Start it small. You are not in a race. You're not in a race. You can start small and you can build. No one is behind you telling you you have to do it all in one day. It was tough for me to learn that because I am a get it done kind of girl, but I've really, really, truly embraced this. You know, like with our renovation, I wanted it done in a day, but I knew that wasn't possible and it took us weeks, but we did it. Right now, you know, if you watch my channel, I'm working on decluttering, reorganizing, and cleaning out the basement. Do I want it done in a day? I absolutely did. But you know what? I've changed my mindset. I'm focusing on different things. The first thing I did was I macro decluttered. I just went to each shelf and got rid of what I knew.
Okay.
It did it again. It just shut right off. So that means I need to just stop talking and end this video. But like I was saying real quick, you know, I went into the basement and I just macro decluttered. I just went shelf by shelf and got rid of what I knew I didn't want. And that took me 2 days. Now I'm going back and fine tuning everything and reorganizing and repurposing and, you know, kind of micro fine tuning and getting rid of more things and things like that. So little steps. Basically, that's what I'm trying to tell you. Little steps in every aspect of your life, not just your Weight Watchers journey. You can use these tools in every aspect of your life. I know I am. So that is it. I'm sorry this was so long. I'm sorry you had to look at Aria for a while, but yeah. Hot mess as always, because you know what I always say? It's real life around here. It's real life. There's no special equipment. There's no special lighting. There's nothing. It's just me, my phone, my tripod that's actually looks like it's breaking. Real life. So I am going to go have my breakfast because it smells absolutely delicious. And I know that Doug is probably starving. I can't believe he's not up here wondering where his breakfast is. So I will talk to you all later. Have a fantastic day. Have a fantastic week. Let me know in the comments below how you guys did this week. Did you have any scale or non-scale victories? Let me know because I plan on having a fantastic week this week. I really do. An on-plan, fantastic week. Have a great one, everyone. If you haven't subscribed, please hit that subscribe button. If you know someone who could use this video, please feel free to share it. Have a great day.